Good morning, everyone. My name is Mighty Stream. I'm going to do your July the 21st just for today in a meditation. If you need to reach me, feel free to do so at recoveryofhope21@gmail.com. I'm excited about our meditation today and spending time together. So I greet you this morning. All right, struggling to get it up, so just bear with me. Okay, tell me a little bit about what you've been doing since the last time we got together. Huh? Have you been recovering your tail off? That's amazing. Just the fact that we have an opportunity to recover. Considering how close many of us came to death, I think that's beautiful. Okay, the title of your meditation for today is Surrender is for Everyone. If after a period of time, we find ourselves in trouble with our recovery, we have probably stopped doing one or more of the things that helped us in the earlier stages of our recovery. That comes from the basic text, page 95. Surrender is just for newcomers, right? Wrong. After we've been around a while, some of us succumb to a condition particular to old timers. We think we know something about recovery, about God, about NA, about ourselves, and we do. The problem is we think we know enough, and we think that merely knowing enough voice fail. Sorry about that, guys. It says the problem is we think we know enough, and we think that merely knowing is enough. But it's what we learn and what we do after we think we know it all that really makes the difference. Conceit and complacency can land us in deep trouble. When we find that applying the principles on our own power just isn't working, we can practice what worked for us in the beginning, surrender. When we find we are still powerless, our lives, again, unmanageable, we need to seek the care of a power greater than ourselves. And when we discover that self-therapy isn't so therapeutic after all, we need to take advantage of the therapeutic value of one addict helping another. Just for today, I need guidance, support, and a power beyond my own. I will go to a meeting, reach out to a newcomer, call my sponsor, pray to my higher power. I will do something that says, I surrender. Let's take a moment of silence, followed by the wee version of the Serenity Prayer. Moment of silence now, please. Thank you. God, grant us the serenity to accept the things that we cannot change, the courage to change the things that we can, and the wisdom to know the difference. Just for today. Just for today, please and thank you. So how powerful is that? Surrender is for everyone. Surrender is for everyone. It's not just for individuals just coming to the program learning how to surrender, right? It's not just for them. It's for old timers too. People that have accumulated some time, a few years here and there, and they are now, knowledgeable about the 12 steps and the traditions and the spiritual principles they're in. And right. It's for them too. And if everyone's being completely honest, we all have hit speed bumps in our recovery. Situations where everything that we know to do just doesn't seem to be working. All of the ways that we've learned to apply ourselves just does not seem to be enough. And that's where the serenity prayer is helpful. God, grant me the serenity to accept the things that I cannot change, the courage to change the things that I can, and the wisdom to know the difference. Because in that, you will figure out what it is you need to surrender again to your higher power so that you can move on. You can accept that this is not something that is for me to change. I keep trying to apply my best self to this, and it's nothing is different. This may be where the wisdom to know the difference is in question. Maybe you're not sure that this is not for you to change. But once you become sure of it, you'll surrender it to your higher power. And when you surrender it, guess what? A true surrender, you'll stop obsessing about the results, because that's what we do, right? We give it to God, and then God doesn't seem to be moving fast enough. We're doing all the things that we know to do, and it isn't changing fast enough. So we take it back. And we take it back in our minds and our spirits, right? Sometimes with our physical bodies as well, we start doing things to actually get our hands actually back into the mix of it. The dough is already done, right? The dough is already done. All of the ingredients are already in the dough. The dough is already mixed very well. And there's no need for you to take it back out and start mixing it again. Let God knead it. Let God put the pressure on it. Let God work out the air bumps. Let God bake it. Let God tell you when it's done. Take your hands off of it. Resurrender. Give it back to God. Do the things that you can do. Go to a meeting, reach out to a newcomer, call your sponsor, pray to your higher power. Do those things. But all that other stuff, you need to pull back and let God have it. My name is Mighty Stream. I've enjoyed your company today. I hope that you have a beautiful day on purpose. I intend to. I look forward to talking to you tomorrow.